I'm calling this meeting of council to order for January 17th. Call the roll.
Maddox. Russell. Hart.
Here.
Cobb. Kuda.
Here.
Larson.
Here.
Okay, any amendments to the agenda? No? Okay. Communications from the mayor.
Thank you, Madam President. First thing, I would like to make sure I do not neglect to request permission to bid project number 2301 Cuyahoga Lee Road Resurfacing, ODOT PID 112874. Make this a matter of record. Do we need a motion?
No.
All right, just like to make that a matter of record.
Okay.
Second, I would like to inform council and the public that starting on the 20th of January, First Energy has contracted with a company to perform inspections of certain transmission lines. The form of that inspection is unique and not something I've heard before. It will be done by helicopter. And so, starting on the 20th, we've been informed by First Energy that their transmission lines will be inspected via helicopter throughout their entire service area. So if you happen to see helicopters buzzing around, hovering, following transmission lines, that is what they are doing. So if anybody asks you any questions about helicopters flying around the city, it may just be inspections of transmission lines.
Mayor? We shouldn't tell them then that they're black helicopters.
Please, let's not contribute to the conspiracy theories. All right, so I would also like to mention both to the public and to council, again, a reminder that the Martin Luther King Jr. Essay, Poetry, and Art Contest celebration is this Thursday at 7 p.m. at the Community Center. And I want to provide special thanks to the council president and vice president who joined city staff in judging the entries. And I welcome all of our council members to join us that evening and participate in providing awards to the winning selections. I would like to mention in the last snowstorm that we had, the last snowfall event that we had, I want to say that we received no complaints in the mayor's office for snow clearing and salting. Now, we didn't receive any compliments either, so, but I recognize that public service has a tendency to be a mostly thankless job, so I'll take that as a win and sort of make up for it. I'd like to thank our Department of Public Works staff and our Parks and Rec staff for getting out there, salting, working overnight, making sure that our streets were safe and our public lots were plowed. And thinking about Parks and Rec staff, I did want to make a brief announcement that we have made a selection in the replacement of our Parks and Rec director. Kelly Ledbetter will be joining us from the city of Atlanta. I look forward to making the new director at home here in Cleveland Heights. And the director should be starting in the first half of February. We're still sort of sorting out the details, but I look forward to the community and all of you, you know, meeting them and moving forward from there. I'm thinking about Parks and Rec. I wanted to mention some information about our ICE facilities at the community center. And this is to sort of expand on some of the information that was in the email that I sent council last week. We all know we've had a series of problems arise at our North Rink most recently, you know, an ongoing problem of leaks in the coolant system that is infiltrating into the ice, potentially causing a problem there. Most recently, as a result of the deep freeze that we had, There were some issues with ice getting, air getting trapped between the ice and the concrete, which created some problems and necessitated as a result of the water going down in the community center in the sprinkler system, needing to be repaired before we could open it back up after the pipes burst. This was sort of an ancillary problem that was created by that situation with air getting trapped between the ice and the concrete, which necessitated us taking the rink down and trying to figure out if this is going to be an ongoing issue. Another issue that arose during that time was sort of a heaving of the concrete under the ice above the headers for the cooling pipes. And so these are things that we are actively working to, A, discern the extent of the problem and what we need to do about it, but also, B, trying to get that rink up and running again as quickly as we can. So I've met with our contractor, our ice contractor, and had some conversation there, and we will be working over the next few days to try to get the north rink back up and running. We'll also be looking at the south rink because, as we all know, it's been out of use for quite some time. And according to the people who did the work on it the last time it needed servicing, and I believe in maybe 2018, that rink has some issues with the galvanized steel as well. So our hope is to get the north rink back up and running to close out the season. And that's going to be the first step over the next couple days, looking at the north rink to see if we can get it back into operation, taking a look at the south rink to see what is possible with that rink. And I look forward to providing hopefully good news in the near future. I'll keep you all appraised of our work on that task. And with that, my comments are complete. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. Okay, report of the Clerk of Council.
Just to notify Council that notice has been received from the Ohio Division of Liquor Control advising that two applications have been made by the following: Dave's Supermarket Inc., doing business as Dave's Market at 1940 Lee Road in Cleveland Heights, Ohio, for a liquor agency contract, and for the transfer of a C2, C2X, D6, D8 liquor permit from York Lee Inc., doing business as Zagar's Marketplace, at the same address, to Dave's Supermarket Inc., doing business as Dave Market. I also would like to just thank the mayor personally and everyone who worked on getting my office done. So,
great. Thank you. Well, I'll have to make a trip there and see her new office. Next, we have public comment on agenda items.
All of our comments are for non-agenda items.
Our comments are for non-agenda items. Okay. Fortunately, we have a fairly short thing here today. So, let's move forward with legislation. Councilwoman Russell.
Thank you, President Hart. Resolution number 003-2023, first reading, a resolution expressing the concern of the residents and City Council for delays in the United States Postal Service mail deliveries in several Cleveland Heights neighborhoods over the past several months, and further expressing the appreciation of the residents and City Council to our U.S. postal carriers who are working long hours due to significant staffing shortages.
Okay, thank you. Second?
Second.
Okay, any discussion? Okay, all in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passed. Planning and Development is next.
Thank you, Madam President. I have resolution number 004-2023, a resolution authorizing the mayor to execute an agreement with Friends of Mendelssohn, a nonprofit corporation, for payment of funding to Naylor Wellman, LLC, for historic preservation services related to the placement of Park Synagogue, 3300 Mayfield Road, Cleveland Heights, on the National Registry of Historic Places and designation of such building as a national landmark, and declaring the necessity of this legislation become immediately effective as an emergency. And I move for its passage this evening.
Second.
Okay, thank you. Is there discussion? Okay, let's do roll call.
Maddox.
Aye.
Russell.
Aye.
Hart.
Aye.
Cobb.
Aye.
Kuda.
Aye.
Larson.
Aye.
Okay, motion passed. Municipal Services, Vice Chair.
Resolution number 005-2023, first reading. A resolution authorizing an agreement with Classic Ford of Madison for the purchase of 4 pickup trucks with 3 plows for the Parks and 3 for the Park and Recreation Department and 1 for the Department of Public Works, and declaring necessary. I'm messing it all up today. Tongue-tied, yes. Declaring necessity that this legislation become immediately effective as emergency measure.
Is there a second?
Second.
Okay. Any discussion? Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion passed. Okay, the next one is a first reading only. And Municipal Services?
Resolution number 006-2023, first reading. A resolution authorizing the mayor to enter into the 5th Amendment to the agreement with Wade Trim, Inc. of Ohio for professional engineering services relating to the city's sanitary sewer overflow control project and the EPA partial consent decree, and declaring this necessary that this legislation become immediately effective as an emergency measure.
Okay, and I'm going to be assigning that to Municipal Services Committee for further discussion. Second.
Madam President, when is that meeting, and is it going to be before the next time this is read?
She has not said when she's going to have her meeting yet. Okay. So
she just assigned it.
Yeah, I just assigned it today. So
fair enough.
Yeah. Okay, second readings, finance. A resolution authorizing the mayor to execute an agreement with Schonard and Associates for the provision of assistance to the city's finance department in the preparation of 2022 and through 2024 annual comprehensive finance reports, providing compensation therefore, and declaring the necessity that this legislation become immediately effective as an emergency measure. And for the public, we used to have the state do this for us, but they don't have anyone available for us this year. However, the person who is the firm that's going to do this for us is charging us the same amount as the state this year and will be charging us less than the state in the next 2 years. And is there a second?
Second.
Okay. Any discussion? Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passed. Now we have our consent agenda. Clerk?
I have resolution number 007-2023, a resolution proclaiming February 2023 to be American Heart Month and declaring the necessity that this legislation become immediately effective as an emergency measure. We also have resolution number 008-2023, a resolution recognizing that February 2023 as Black History Month and declaring the necessity that this legislation become immediately effective as an emergency measure.
Okay, thank you. We need a motion to suspend rules.
So moved.
Second.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Okay, then we need a motion to adopt.
So moved.
Second.
Okay, any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Motion passed. Now we have our committee reports. Does anyone have a committee report this evening? Councilor Larson.
Thank you, Madam President. The Public Safety and Health Committee committee met today. Councilors Kuda, Russell, and myself started work on legislation that will potentially set up a sidewalk repair program. We'll be inviting the law department and appropriate city staff to help us design the legislation at future meetings of this committee. We also determined that we need to do further research before we write any legislation on any sidewalk snow removal program. The discussion on this issue turned towards some pilot programs, possible partnerships with groups that could organize a contact for people who need help shoveling their walks and people who are willing to volunteer. We also ask for input from the law department and appropriate city staff as we move forward. I announced to the committee that Mayor Sarin and Noble Elementary's Principal Carpenter will be holding a community meeting at Noble on January 26th to discuss the traffic pattern issue during drop-off and pickup times at the school. The next regularly scheduled meeting of the Public Safety and Health Committee is February 21st at 10 a.m.
Thank you. Thank you, Councilor Larson.
Welcome.
Yes, Councilor.
Thank you, Councilman Hart. I just wanted to let people know that the community center is now reopened for regular hours. The recycle refuse a delay by one day, so please check the holiday schedule. Also, the mayor mentioned about the, I won't go into that, mentioned about the Martin Luther King celebration on Thursday the 19th. What else for Parks and Recs? Meet the Police is Thursday the 19th at 6 o'clock, 6 to 8. It's in the lower level of this building, City Hall. Also, don't forget the speed limits have dropped to 25. Look for the new signs on top of the speed limits. The Commission on Aging's meeting is Friday, January 20th at 9:30 a.m. And also, this was just sent to me, and I think I'm going to mention it for the simple fact I think it will be something great for the city as well as for the school district. The Attorney General's office has just offered a New Year's limited time innovation grant up to $20,000, which will be awarded for technology that links to schools with law enforcement agencies for improved safety, criminal prevention, and response. A total of $11.77 million will be spent towards public safety around schools and intertwining it with the city and the police. So I've sent this to our superintendent, Ms. Kirby, and to various different school districts around Northeast Ohio, along with the municipalities, to see if they can partner up with the school districts as well and get some of that money to help our be safe. So that concludes my report.
Thank you. Councilor Maddox.
Thank you, Madam President. Just two things to report. The Planning and Development Committee met today at 5 o'clock, and we discussed the appraisal gap program, quite a bit to flesh out still. And so expect to see a meeting concerning that probably earlier half of February. In addition, we were sent over the recommendations from the Planning Commission, the Cleveland Heights Planning Commission today. And so looking forward to starting those conversations as well. So that will also be on the agenda for February's Planning and Development Committee. So that's appraisal gap and the Planning Commission recommendations for changes to city ordinances, zoning, things like that. We'll be discussing those recommendations as well, again, early part of February. Stay tuned for that. You'll find out that information as well on the city's website as soon as we post the agenda and the date. And that's all I have. Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you. Any others? Okay. Now we will have a public comment for things that are not about the agenda. Do we have any?
Brian Hare.
Hi, everybody. So my name is Brian Hare. I live on Cedar Road. I'm speaking on my own behalf this evening. Thank you, Council, for the opportunity to share and your work serving our community. So I just, unfortunately, wanted to add an alternative perspective, possibly in support of a South reconversion to turf. I know that's not a popular perspective right now. And I have complete respect for the ice community and support, you know, them getting a rink back as well. My spouse is a former figure skater, has fond memories of very cold early mornings and stinky locker rooms. And my statements aren't against their desires, but also speaking to, you know, a community that has never necessarily had a space in community facilities before. Lots of turf-based sports could benefit from having that place in the community. Football, field hockey, lacrosse, soccer, basketball, or baseball. Ultimate Frisbee, rugby, some that come to mind. Obviously, there'd be some upfront costs bringing that up to standard, but that could be long-term savings in terms of the maintenance. There'd be less of an environmental impact on our planet, a positive outcome for humanity, and sort of in line with the city's commitment to sustainability. And you could certainly rent that space similar to ICE. You know, I think right now our portfolio of space is a third hard courts and two-thirds ice, and I think a balanced portfolio of one-third, 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 you know, is something reasonable to consider. I mean, obviously, I think ultimately more discussion is warranted, but I think it should be a group conversation and not necessarily something that we, you know, just do on our own. So, again, restating, this isn't a popular position to take, but I think there's a lot of other residents who could benefit from a converted rink. They're probably not aware this conversation's even going on. So I'm just kind of here, give them a voice, provide a different perspective. And thank you again for your consideration of my thoughts. Again, and to these ICE advocates showing up to fight for their rink as well. Ultimately, I'm grateful to be living in a community with all of these resources at our disposal. Definitely an embarrassment of riches. So thank you. That's all.
Thank you.
David Lavelle.
Good evening. My name is David Lavelle. I'm a business owner. I started a business about 30 years ago in Cleveland Heights. Also a resident in Cleveland Heights the last 30 years. In fact, my company partnered with the city in raising the capital for the Recreation Center, selling the bonds directly to Cleveland Heights residents. The City of Cleveland Heights website, Parks and Recreation section, reads, "Thanks to the voters' passage of the 1997 recreation bond issue, Cleveland Heights residents have a state-of-the-art recreation complex that contains, among many things, including a field house, a fitness center, a north rink, which is open year round, it's an Olympic size, and a south rink, which is ice for 6 months and a field house for the other 6 months. So there's not quite the third, a third, a third. In a business sense, I'd ask the question, what is a community center? And the answer is it's a capital investment. And it's the city's responsibility to leverage those assets to their fullest potential. Not neglecting them, squandering both the resources and the opportunity, taking the easy way out, saying, quote, we're inheriting some problems that were a long time coming. Mr. Mayor, do you get your email or do you even read them? Because every coach in town, multiple, that pay money to Cleveland Heights for ice time have no idea what's going on. Zero. Who's in charge? Who has a grasp of what the problems are and, more importantly, can provide some type of a solution? Sure, we're reaching out. We've been hearing that now for multiple weeks. Kids have schedules. Kids my kids are skating in Euclid from 8:30 to 9:30. That's about a 10:15 bedtime by the time you get back home. Makes for a great day the next day. Now, running an ice rink, or for that matter, two into the ground, is quite easy. What do? You upset the people that are currently paying. They stop running your ice. You generate no revenue. You have only one rink, so it's impossible to hold a hockey tournament, which I think can generate close to $100,000 of revenue, not to mention all the accessory business that comes to the Cleveland Heights community. With one rink, you're eliminating the possibility of our own constituents to use the rink for open skates, parties, things like that. So you've stated that there'd be a public discussion, yet you approve budgets with no money whatsoever to maintain these assets. I mean, it's destined to fail. Under the current way. I mean, this is what people raised money, people invested their money for two ice rinks, not one that we're gonna run into the ground for a year or two and then say, okay, we've got a better option here. The reality is two functioning rinks can and should work. The city raised millions of dollars on this premise and it's worked extremely well for many years. The lack of attention to maintaining a community center is ruining the kids' hockey season. You know, they go through, I think, into early March, and it's ruined. I mean, my kids are like, are we going to have to go to a different rink? So please let us know, you know, or maybe you can respond to an email to everyone that sent you one, exactly what your plans are and when they're going to happen and sort of lay out some communication so we can at least deal with our schedules the remainder of the hockey season. Thank you.
Your time's up. Thank you.
Mike Watson.
And just, I should have said this at the beginning, that there's a clock there, you have 3 minutes, and that it'll make a little sound kind of like a cell phone, which will make you wonder if your cell phone's going off when your time is up. Okay.
I'm also here to talk about the ice rinks. To address the gentleman who was here prior about converting it to turf, We have a Cadillac in the South Rink. The facility that was built, I think it was back in the 70s, that became the South Rink, that rink has a raised floor, and you can access all of the pipes from underneath, from what I understand. So therefore, it is a very well-constructed facility. The North Rink, you have to raise the floor in order to access the pipes, so it's a different construction altogether. There are plenty of unused facilities within the school district that can be converted to turf, and I don't want to lose a Cadillac in the South Rink. I think we can easily invest in that South Rink to bring it back to fruition. In addition, pre-COVID, I know that the older kids had access to three practices per week, and we don't have that anymore. Essentially, our access to ice time has been cut in half. In addition, not just the hockey program, but the community programs that exist. There are no nighttime skating. There's no access for adults to come after work to skate or learn to skate. They can access it on the weekend. You would have to come up on your lunchtime. I have some questions in general. I'd like to understand what the issues specifically are with the South Rink and the galvanized steel that the mayor mentioned. Can we have an understanding of the funds that are allocated and used for maintenance on the rinks and that have taken place over the past 20 plus years since it was voted on by the citizens of the city in order to establish the second rink, not just have a first rink, but have a second rink as well. And that was voted on. What's the current budget for repair and maintenance for 2023 specifically? You guys all worked on the budget. I'd like to know that specifically. What's the expected timeline for repairs? Will this be a Band-Aid or will this be a long-term fix so that we will know that we have access to the facility? Because every time that we have to cancel practice and find another facility, our organization has to pay, providing an additional hardship on the families that already paid at the beginning of the season to use these facilities when we have to go and access other facilities. In addition, we also have to cancel games. And every time we cancel a game, we pay an additional fee to the program because we have to cancel the game. That affects other families in other cities. Is there a policy against sponsorship for the rink? Is there an issue of possibly just outsourcing the management and function of the rinks to an external program to bring it back to fruition of what it once was? I think that's it. Thanks.
Thank you very much. And Eddie, you'll give me all the names. Okay, thank you.
Joe Tikas.
Yes, my name is Joe Tikas. I'm a resident of Cleveland Heights for almost 45 years, homeowner. I'm here not only for the ice, but the community center in general. I don't understand how this whole problem started. It seems that there were no preventative maintenance. Is that these problems don't just come up? I mean, where's the money going? I was in the community and voted not once but twice for this new community center. You know, the first time it was voted and approved, and then a number of lazy voters within the city who didn't bother to vote stopped the city from starting the construction, and it had to be voted on a second time, and the second time it won by a larger margin than the first time. I don't understand why so many problems are coming up in the expense. You know, the community center is not a money-making proposition, and they're talking about no second ice rink because it doesn't make, it's a money loser. The whole thing is a money loser. You know, the senior citizens, the health center, none of those are profit-making, and they're not supposed to be. They're not, it's a community center. We pay our taxes to have the right and the opportunity to use these, and our taxes goes towards that. And I just don't understand why everything is falling apart. Now, I know it's 20 years old, the new rink, but with proper preventive maintenance, this never should have gotten to this far. It should have been recognized and dealt with so that we don't have, I'm sure this is going to be a huge expense to fix not only one, but both rinks. And one of the gentlemen talked about using South Rink as for something. It's available for more than 6 months. You know, I've like I said, I've been here for over 40 years. They used to have rented out for antique shows and all kinds of different things during the spring, summer, and fall before it became ice again. Every other rink in the greater Cleveland area that I've been to, and I've been to them all, they have sponsorships. They have people, businesses pay to put their logos or whatever along the inside of the boards of the rink. It's huge money profit. And I don't know of a rink in the greater Cleveland that doesn't do that. I mean, that's easy money. There's no, it's just, I just don't understand how the problem got to this point. And, you know, it needs to be fixed. And, you know, I the turf, I totally understand. It's a great idea, but it can be a turf for 6 months. It can be ice for 6 months. We voted for two rinks. And if that's a problem and we can't afford a second rink, then I think the public should vote. We voted to put in two rinks, and if there's not going to be two rinks, there should be a vote to the citizens to decide themselves, because they decided to have.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Jay Tikas.
Hi, good evening, Mayor Sarin and City Council. It's mid-January, and you know we have no ice. The North Rink has been down now for 22 days, and we are in the middle of our season. If this continues through the weekend of January 28th, I will have 18 of the 21 remaining home games at Cleveland Heights to reschedule. We are now attempting to rent from other local rinks. Months ago, I stood here trying to make the point that there is a high demand for ice in Cleveland that Cleveland Heights could profit from, and now I get to be right because I have found options to be limited. I have 32 11 and 12-year-olds that currently don't have a single practice scheduled for next week because we just can't find ice during the week. We've been put in a terrible situation by no fault of our own and request support from our city. I now realize that it's actually not the city that we're asking support from, but it is you, Mayor Sarin. The residents of Cleveland Heights asked for a mayor to be elected, so there is accountability at the top for the tough decisions that are made, and we got one. I do appreciate your update this evening, and I look forward for more towards more starting tomorrow. In hockey, forward skating is obviously important, but we spend just as much time on the ability to pivot. Last week was a time to pivot. The day we learned that the North was being left to melt so repairs could be examined, I emailed you and rink staff suggesting that we clean the floor on the South to bring it back up. We could have tested the pumps while the North melted. I received no reply, and instead we waited, and another six games need to be postponed and rescheduled that could have possibly been played this weekend. That's a $100 game change fee by our league and about $200 for ice rental for each game. And I said there were 21 of them that we need to reschedule if the ice doesn't come back up by the end of the year. Time is not on our side. Our season is now in jeopardy, and it's you who has a unique opportunity to do the right thing and ensure ice for us to close out the year. If ice can't be guaranteed on the North in the next 10 to 14 days, we can still finish out on the South. I'm sure the parents and coaches of the off-season sports that currently conduct gym activities on the South would understand if it was their regular season. I don't blame you or other staff for the years of neglect, but this is where we are, and you and only you have the ability to pick up the phone and make that call. I understand we will know more tomorrow and hope to have an updated timetable for ice on the North. To be clear, we need ice in 10 days, not 2 weeks that turn into four. That's too late. I ask that you do not turn your back on your skating community and do the right thing to provide the infrastructure we need to provide the youth programming that increases the quality of life for your residents. The last 3 weeks we have been down has made it clear that we can't do it alone. Thank you.
Thank you.
Theo Tikas.
Hi, I'm Theo Tigas. I'm in seventh grade at Roxborough Middle School and play for the Eastside Tigers. The current state of the rinks at the rec center is very alarming. My team, the Eastside Tigers PB1 team, is currently 7-0-1, and I would love to finish undefeated, but if our season is ended by this, it will be heartbreaking. If we do get both rinks back up and running, we could have sponsorships for more revenue because every rink besides ours has sponsorships on their boards and banners. And we could go back to hosting tournaments, leading more people to the city, more people buying from local Cleveland Heights businesses, more people bustling around, and putting Cleveland Heights back on the map. Last weekend, I played in a tournament in Pittsburgh. I played in 3 different rinks and saw what is possible. We have all we need to make it happen, except the will and desire to make this decision and make Heights hockey the best it can be. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Chris Lacey.
Chris Lacey from Sheffield Drive. I guess the main positive thing I'd like to say is I appreciate the updates today. That's more than I've heard in the last 2 years, I believe. I don't think we ever heard a reason why the South Rink was shut down, and this is the first I've heard of the repairs being needed. But that's, I guess, my main request, other than everything going better than we obviously are in now, is just better communication, because for the last 2 years, this whole situation has been very poorly communicated to everyone, including the people in charge of any program. There's very little notice of any updates, and I just think financially, if it is a problem, then pitch how it saves money to have a hockey. How much is the soccer players paying to be in this area? Because from what I've heard, I don't think pay a lot of the programs that use the non-ice rink. So that's not really generating revenue. You might have less utility costs, but I think the point is that we've made a lot of points of how money could be recovered to offset any of the utility costs. And so I guess some transparency with regard to the budget and with the difference of the different options. We have heard nothing as far as option A costs the city this much, option B costs the city this much. It's just radio silence and no information. So I think that's my main request, and I'll give you your minute and a half back.
Thank you.
Scott Hindulak, I'm sorry if I pronounced that wrong.
Madam President, Mr. Mayor, Council, thank you very much for letting me talk. I've lived here 40 some years, and all my sons played hockey. I coached for 12 years. After my son played for the high school and went off to college, I hung up my skates and my whistle, and I haven't been to the rink for a really long time. My grandson started playing hockey. I went to go watch him play. I haven't been to the rink for 10, 15 years. I was so disappointed. It's run down. People who work there seem to be apathetic. We used to be a hockey and skating capital, if you will. Cleveland Heights was known for its skating programs, speed skating, hockey, figure skating. What have you guys done to this rink? I know you're not personally responsible, but the city should be really embarrassed. All of you should be embarrassed that one of the crown jewels of this city is decaying. It's just going to waste. Used to be a social center for my children. Used to be a social center for my wife and I. We'd go skating with our friends. The kids would go skating with their friends. There's something wrong here. And it needs to be fixed. We used to be envied by the other communities because our skating program was so fantastic. And now it's just a shell of itself. Something needs to be fixed. I don't like being embarrassed. Imagine these people having to tell the other teams, hey, we can't play because we can't keep ice in our ice rink. Hey, we can't have a tournament because we only have one rink that we can't keep the ice. on the rink. It's embarrassing. Need to fix this. You guys can do it. It's not your fault, but you could be the heroes to fix all this. Put your minds to it. We'll help you, but let's do it. Thank you.
Lisa West.
Hi again. I didn't prepare anything this time, so we're all just going to be surprised at what comes out of my mouth. I have a lot of letters here, a lot. And interestingly enough, as a hockey parent, I really thought most of my letters would be from hockey, but they're not. They're from speed skaters. They're from other people in the community that want to keep this place alive. I was a city employee for 17 years. And I don't know where Turf Guy went, and I give him a lot of credit for standing up here today, and he's not wrong. I drive my daughter every Saturday to Medina to play softball and every Sunday to Willoughby to practice. We do need that, but not at the expense of our ice skating rink. There have been a lot of things mismanaged in there. You mentioned the panel going down because the water. Yes, the panel did go down because of the water. And therefore, people that run the rinks weren't able to be notified that there was an issue. But who would they notify anyway? Because Tom, the foreman that used to be there, has now taken over Andre's job. There's no foreman at the rink. There was nobody dispatched to go check on that ice skating rink during the negative 12 degree temperatures when we had to change from a rink to a warming center. And interestingly enough, when the rink was shut down, the post was still up that it was a warming center. Where's the communication? There's none. It's extremely frustrating. The reason why the pipes froze is because a door on the roof of the rec center was open. A door that has been needed to be repaired for years and has not been repaired was left open. Public Works sent people out to City Hall to make sure that City Hall was not frozen and everything was running properly. Nobody was dispatched to the rink to check on it. I worked for the city for 17 years. I know a lot of people. And I know a lot of things, and I know what goes on up there. And as my stepdad just said, you guys have the opportunity right now to be the heroes. Because nobody knows what's going on. Those of us who are deeply involved don't know what's going on. And we need to know, we need to know, and I want a refund. Do you know how much hockey costs? Do you know how much, I have a goalie. Do you know how much I pay for his equipment? And how much I pay the East Tigers to pay to play hockey? I want a refund. And I'm sure everybody else does too. We need answers and we need this open. And if it was addressed and things were, I talked to your communications director today who was kind enough to give me a call, probably because he heard about all my complaints and spoke out to somebody who was able to give him my phone number. Communication needs to change. He is aware of that and you guys need to be aware of it and make it happen. And as far as not answering emails, I've done you a favor and I've printed out a bunch of them for you. If anybody would like to take them. Thank you.
Jennifer Bartlett.
Excuse me. Excuse me. Were you intending to give those to us?
Oh, I'd love to.
Oh, absolutely. Thank you.
Council, Mayor, thank you so much for having us here today and letting us exercise our civic opportunities. I'm here as a parent of not just a hockey child, but also two scouts that are here learning about civics and what it means to be part of a community. I've been here in this community for now 20 years. I moved from the dark side on the west side, crossed the river, and came over here. And I'm a homeowner. I have two children. When I moved in, I saw this rec center and I thought, oh great, there's an indoor swimming pool, it's gonna be wonderful. And then I learned it was two hockey rinks and I said, what the heck? 13 years later, my 13-year-old son skates here. He started by himself. He, at 11 years old, started figuring out how to take his bike from my house on Sylvania Road down to the rec center by himself. He earned money to pay for open skates so he could teach himself how to skate. That's how badly he wanted to play hockey when I said no. I know the expense, it's $800. That's what I paid this year. That does not include his gear. That does not include the $1,000 that we spent for a tournament in Pittsburgh this weekend. I did that because he has a dream to play hockey. I ask that you really do take a hard look at this. And if we are able to repair these rinks, and I hope that we are, that we can look forward. Who can we leverage? I am willing to go talk to GE even, if myself, if you don't have someone to do so. I have a lot of things on my plate, but I'm willing to set things aside to make sure these kids have the opportunities that they want. And these adults that want to learn how to skate as well. There's no reason we can't have an extra building added on for a field house. We could turn this into a world-class facility. We have lots of property. Severance Town Center has lots of space. We could even leverage that into a tournament opportunity. We could bring in a lot of revenue for the city. We could bring in a lot of goodwill. We could also protect the health of our community by promoting that exercise, whether it be skating, field sports, indoor swimming, anything. But I ask that you really take a hard look and see if we can repair these, how can we keep them going in the future? How can we maintain them? Case skates there, Benedictine High School skates there. I'm sure those two places would be willing to have those conversations for capital improvements as well and be that partner of this community. Thank you.
Thank you.
Last but not least, it looks like we've got a couple of skaters, Max, Vinny, and Zeke.
I just wanted to talk about us getting our rink back. I started playing hockey 3 years ago, I think it was. And this year, for me personally, I could have played for my school, Mayfield. But I chose not to, and to play for the Eastside Tigers with my friends. And it's really disappointing to not be able to get to practice with them at our home ice. Not too long ago, we had a practice at 9 at night at a rink that was, I think, 45 minutes away. I had midterms the next morning at 7 in the morning, but I wanted to see my teammates that I haven't seen in weeks since our rink was closed, so I chose to go to that practice. I don't see why this is such a big problem. There are so many teams that practice here that are all wishing to practice at our rink. All of the away teams that come to our rink a few years ago, they would always tell us how nice our rink was, but of course they don't get to see it now that we, since it's been closed. I would really like to get it back open and have our normal practices 2 days a week, Tuesday and Thursday. Today, I had my friends over to practice in the street with street hockey. It's just not the same as the ice because we couldn't have the whole team. It's really inconvenient. But we would just really would like both rinks back up, if possible, at least one that we can skate on. I learned how to play hockey on the north rink, and Zeke here did too. I'm sure Max grew up on those ices, and it's just very inconvenient to have to have late practices because that's the only times we can get and have them be at other rinks that are further away. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, so is there any old business, new business? Okay, council member comments. These should relate directly to the business of the city of Cleveland Heights rather than personal reflection or commentary. We have a 3-minute time limit. Does anyone have any comment? Yes, councilwoman?
Yes, I just want to thank all the children who came up today to exercise their civil rights. It's very nice, very nice. Also, I'd like to congratulate all of the people that winners for the Martin Luther King event that's coming up this Thursday. And reason I'm mentioning that, because I may not be able to be in attendance because my grandson is playing Martin Luther King in his event. So I may be running late or I may be there, but I just wanted to make sure I gave a congratulations to all the people who submitted. You are all winners, and those who are chosen are still winners. So thank you so very much.
Thank you. Any other? Councilwoman, wait, who's first? Councilwoman Larson? Okay, Councilor Kuda.
To all the hockey enthusiasts here, I want to tell you, I'm very moved by all of you. I have that same passion for sports. I grew up here. I went through the high school system. I still play hardball in an organized league. And I would be devastated if, you know, I couldn't play my games. I, for what it's worth, I really appreciate your passion, and I hope this all gets worked out. yesterday being Martin Luther King Day, growing up in Cleveland Heights, I hope this isn't too much musing, but, what an honor it was to grow up with that man. As a, you know, I see some people here of similar ages of me. Whenever he would come on television and speak, my household just froze. You know, we were just captivated by him and his message. And it's hard to believe that he was assassinated at 39 years old. I mean, that's, you know, I look back and I think what a young man he was, but he was so wise that I guess as a kid thought of him as an older man, you know, because usually, that kind of wisdom comes from that. But it's just so great to be in Cleveland Heights in a place where his message is resonating to this day. And, certainly we still have a lot of work to do. But what an honor it was to, you know, have my life intersect with his. And that concludes my comments. Thank you.
Councilwoman Larson.
Thank you, Madam President. Thank you all for coming this evening and exercising your right to express your opinion. It's really important, and we appreciate it. I attended the grand opening of the Heights Wellness Center this afternoon at Heights High. The partnership between the CHUH School District and Metro Health is going to be a blessing to our entire community. A lot of people and partnerships worked together to build this wonderful center. CHUH City School District students, their families, staff members can now receive routine health care at the Heights Wellness Center inside Cleveland Heights High School. Services are provided by Metro Health and include physicals, annual sports, work permit, injury, illness care, mental behavioral health, immunizations, care for chronic conditions like asthma and diabetes, routine lab tests, and telehealth. It was a very impressive tour that we saw today, and I'm looking forward to it being used by our citizens. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, so for my report, I just want to thank you all for coming. I hear what you're saying, and I hear you're wanting to have those rinks. We do know there are problems with the rinks, and certainly we want to move to get these issues taken care of. We have your name and contact information, which we'll pass along to the administration, but I'll have a copy of it as well, and we'll try to reach out to you when I have information. On Martin Luther King, I had to score some of the students and learned a lot that I didn't know about Martin Luther King. I mean, I knew he was civil rights and all that kind of stuff, but there was a lot about him that is surprising and I hadn't known. So I thought it was really interesting reading it. I also found out other things that weren't about Martin Luther King. Like, I always knew what a haiku, because they could write poems. I knew what a haiku was, 5 syllables, 7 syllables, 5 syllables. But I found out what a tanka was, which has 2 more with, I think it's 7 letters, 2 more lines. And there's a diamante poem, which has to be, like, you have nouns on certain things and verbs on certain things, and they go in a diamond. So I learned a lot from reading what these kids had to say, both about Martin Luther King and about poetry as well. So if you can make it to that on Thursday night, it'll be a nice event. You'll get to see these students who've really done a good job. I mean, they all have done a good job, but the ones who are going to be awarded there. That being said, our meeting is adjourned, and I thank you all.